Hi. Here we are at the end of the first week of Parliament. It's been an interesting week. We sort of started off on Tuesday, and as the opposition we were waiting for this momentous speech from the Prime Minister, and we're getting ready for, you know, for the onslaught of a great vision and sort of speech that she was going to give that was going to rock the world. And it was a bit of fizzer, to be honest with you. It didn't really take off at all, and was quite disappointing, I think, for many New Zealanders not to hear the real issues that need to be addressed, being addressed, and to hear stuff about sort of housing affordability that seems so distant and so far off that what they haven't got in 9 years, it's sort of, you know, are we going to wait another nine to sort of see any sort of results? And so it was quite unbelievable, because John got up and did his reply, and it was quite outstanding. He spoke from his heart, which always makes a difference, really. It's been an interesting week. I thought I'd talk to you a little bit. I started on Monday at a child forum, and it was academics and practitioners and people that work in the early childhood sector and parents and a number of people, and we really debated the sort of issues around parenting and early childhood care and education, what care and education actually meant, what parents' expectations were from services, how they were being met, and perhaps what the future meant. And what kept coming out that day was that I suppose us looking at this sort of woman of my generation, we thought we could have it all. You know, we thought we could work and have these big careers, and we thought we could raise our families, and the reality has been difficult, and we need sort of state assistance, and we need help to sort of do that, those sorts of things. And then I find myself in the situation here on a Thursday and going, well, wow, I've just seen such an example of that this week with the resignation of a good friend of mine and a colleague that I just greatly admire, of Catherine Rich, who's, you know, made that choice that actually, you know, family and raising them and having this sort of job is a really difficult place to be in. So it just raises the debate and raises those issues that I think we need to talk about a bit more as a society, is who is raising our children? You know, are we actually supporting families enough so that they have choices? I mean, that's what National stands for. We stand for that choice. But choice is a fine word to use. Is it a reality for many people, or are they being forced into doing things that perhaps they wouldn't ideally choose for their families? And how do we, as perhaps a future government, actually step up to that challenge? And what role does government play when it's actually, you know, we're about actually letting families get on and do what they do, but there's obviously a role for government as well. So yeah, that's a few of my thoughts this week, and I'm not going to sit here and give you all the answers today. The reality is that you've probably got them yourself. So, you know, contact me. I'd love to hear from you and love to hear a bit about what you think about those sorts of issues and perhaps your own personal circumstances and how you get through them. So thanks for having a listen to me today.